We grew up in a place called Phoenix, Arizona, which is an isolated desert city in the middle of a huge dust bowl. You had to watch TV there, you see, because it was so oppressingly hot. You were in the house watching TV veritably all day long. All day long watching TV.
The negotiations that led to these treaties began $1,180 in the jackpot.
You had to watch every new thing they put at you. And this went on for 15 years, you know. And imagine what that does to a person. They grow up and they're totally nuts.
A set of luggage.
The tubes were ahead of the curve. They were the curve.
The Tubes came to San Francisco in 1969. They were considered a freak band at first, but two albums and two national tours later, the Tubes are now considered a city tradition. San Francisco loves them. And if you've never heard of a rock band with TV sets, a choreographer, and foam rubber props, neither has anybody else. The Tubes are a first.
You know, we were a cult band. We were a crazed, over-the-top cult band that did whatever we wanted. If we got in trouble, we didn't care. If we had naked dancers, we didn't care. If people thought we were insane, we didn't care. If the songs weren't big hits, we didn't care. It didn't matter.
The politics of the band were clearly the most interesting thing about the band, and that there was, and the politics were quite pointed, and they were quite militant.
That's right. I'm Quai Lute of the Tubes, and we plan to save your city.
It's no surprise that things such as This Is Spinal Tap happened in the wake of the Tubes and in the wake of Fee Waybill's character Quaalude, who was the quintessential loaded, selfish, arrogant, doped up, oversexed, incompetent rock star.
You watch them, you find yourself with a grin on your face the whole time, and really that's what it was all about, you know.
We wanted to be like you guys. We were really knocked out with it.
We were a living theater organization, and we were in constant workshop, and everybody participated.
You know, it was like one flew over the cuckoo's nest or something, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it was a blizzard of drugs and sex and wild times and total insanity.
Listen, the Tubes was either going to be a magnificent success or a magnificent failure. But there was certainly going to be the word magnificent attached to it.
White folks are